If you would indulge me the privilege of addressing you from the chair, it's unusual for the chair to do that, but I hope no one will raise the point. A few weeks ago, we embarked on a journey to create landmark national legislation that dealt not just with children with autism, but children with all developmental disabilities. I felt then, as I do now, that Florida has an opportunity to do it right and do it well, do it very well. And I am disappointed that we have not been able to put something together that accomplishes our goals. Before us today, we have a Senate message that Representative Gardiner and others will explain in a moment. And that Senate message deals with children with autism. Unfortunately, it will only cover 14% of those children in the state that have autism. And that number will decline as the years go on, as that mandate kicks in. It does create a mechanism for a compact where insurers will negotiate with the state to provide coverage for these children. But there's no leverage. There is no mandate hanging over the head of insurers that will ever ensure that they will ever provide that coverage. The result is that this bill will leave many kids who desperately need these services, including children that you and I represent and know personally, and behind. Now, you may say, why is that a problem? Why is that a problem? After you have an opportunity to help 14% of the kids, that's better than nothing, and that's a step forward. And here's the problem. The problem with that is that my experience in this process has been that when we do things, no one ever wants to get back to them. Once you address it once, no one ever wants to go back to it. And that was an experience that I had on something I felt very strongly about, and that was property taxes. And I was disappointed that even after we were able to pass that, we never dealt with an issue that I thought was so important. And so I struggled with that, and I was just laughing with these members. Isn't it ironic that after all we've been through together in this chamber, that my last decision as Speaker would be the most important and the most difficult? And I'll tell you why it's difficult, because it's about, this is not a tax cut. This is about real children and real parents and real families, and who are struggling every single day to make ends meet. And some of those families are in this room. Some of those families are sitting in these desks. And I value the work you've done deeply. And I am saddened that we will not have before us legislation that will address your concerns. But I feel today strongly, after thinking about it, praying about it, talking to so many of you up here, that I don't want the last decision that we make here on this issue, one that had united us. You know, the Florida House gets criticized a lot for being a raucous, partisan, you know, place with a lot of noise. All of those things are true. But every now and then we come together, and I always tell people, when you get a unanimous vote out of the House, it's pretty special. And we got one on this issue, and I'm proud that it united us. I really, truly am. And I'm saddened that it has the potential to divide us at this moment. I ask you not to allow that to be the case. If this issue is about anything else, taxes, anything, I would tell you, don't do it. Let's come back and get it right and do it completely right. But it has to do with children and with families. And even if it's just 14% of them, I think we have to take a step forward. I know today you gave me season tickets to the Miami Dolphins. I value it very, very much. But I ask you, for those that are coming back, to do something instead. Pledge to each other today, those of you who are returning and those of you who will serve in the Senate next year, including, I hope, Representative Gardiner. I hope he will be a senator in 6 months. I believe that he will be, and I believe he will rise to leadership in that chamber. Pledge to each other today that we will not allow this issue to end, that we will not forget the rest of the children who this does not cover, that we will not forget the development of disabled children who are not covered by the measure that is about to pass, I hope, that we will not allow this to become like the other issues that we do in this legislative process, that after we deal with something called reform or change, we move on to another topic. Promise each other and pledge today that that will not be the case. I will be a private citizen next year. All I'll be able to do is call you on the phone, write letters to the editor, and urge you on. But understand this obligation. Let it be the parting legacy of this House that we started the process, that we got the ball rolling, that we took an enormous step forward. I hope that this will happen in our time. I hope it will happen in your time, those of you who are returning. Take up and read Senate Bill 2654.
The Honorable Marco Rubio, Speaker. I'm directed to inform the House of Representatives that the Senate has refused to concur in House Amendment 1 to CS for Senate Bill 2654 and requests the House to recede. By the Committee on Health and Human Services Appropriations, the Committee on Health Policy, the Committee on Banking and Insurance, and Senator Geller and others, CS for Senate Bill 2654, a bill to be entitled an act relating to autism spectrum disorder.
Representative Gardiner.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Members, this is the essentially the Senate position. And as the Speaker said, it only covers autism. It does not cover other disabilities. And I would move that we concur with the Senate and take it up and pass it and send it to the governor.
Representative Gardiner moves that we recede from the House position and concur in the Senate amendment. All those in favor signify by saying yay.
Yay.
Opposed, no. Motion passes. We are on final passage of Senate Bill 2654. The clerk will lock the machine and announce the vote.
117 yeas, 0 nays, Mr. Speaker.
By your vote, the bill passes.